Hi, on my website Diesel Tech Ron, I get quite a few questions. I get dozens of questions every day, and I'd say 20-30% of them, the people, everybody's asking me about a crank no start or a stalling issue. So that tells me it's time to make a video for it. So what I want to do is cover the basics, what I look for, why I look for it, and how I look for it, and try to do this all, and hopefully when you guys write with me, I can just reference this video. So the truck comes in, like such as this truck, I just got it towed here, it is a crank no start, and so I started thinking about what do I use, what can I suggest for you guys to use. It's a good opportunity to make a video. So first thing we do is we quiz the customer, made sure there's no gasoline in the tank. If there's gasoline, you pull the cap off, you can smell it right away. This one has diesel fuel, so it's not an issue. This one's actually used to be a long crank cold, and then it became a no start completely. Now also a couple things I want to touch on. If the truck's never been worked on, then the no start issue is most likely either going to be the ficum or the some type of injection problem. If it's an 03, 04, it's going to be most likely an injection pump. If it's an 05 and up, it's going to be either a coupler or something. And that's going to be seen with low ICP. If it's an 03 all the way up, cover all the years, and it's a no start or runs rough or anything else, that's most likely going to be a ficum. If you have other issues, which I'll try to briefly touch here in a few minutes, then we got it, or if it's been worked on, then we've got to go into more in-depth testing, which I'll show here on this video, then make more in-depth videos as we go along. So here, what I would suggest, if you have a shop, the first thing you might want to do, if you work on quite a few of these or you make a living with it, you probably want to spend the extra money. I know it's expensive. You've got more than a couple $1,000 by the time you buy a laptop, or maybe you already have one, but you buy a VCM that's well over $1,000. Subscriptions over $600 a year, but if you get the VCM set up and you have this, you can go and do a whole lot more. It's not just your basic code puller. You can go in there and do more bi-directional controls. You can check it out. It's a whole lot better system to have. The second best, as far as if you have a shop and you don't do a lot of power strokes, Auto Ingenuity. It works really good. You still have the bi-directional controls. You buy the Ford Enhance. It's actually very good. The only thing is, I found that as far as watching cylinder contribution and relative compression, can't beat the IDS. None of the manufacturers, nobody else I know of does better than what this does. But for the average home guy, they're not going to be investing this, especially if you only have one or two trucks, so you just want to fix yours. So that's what I'm going to cover here real quick. If you want to try to look at it today and get it done quick, then just go by AutoZone, get the scan gauge. I have a video showing how to program it. We can go in and look at it. Because always, which I'm going to be showing here in a second, when you have the crank no start, what we need to know is the ICP, injection control pressure. We need to know the true pressure. We need to know the voltage, and the voltage is always important, because if the voltage is gone, what you see as far as the pressure, it's not true. And we also want to look at ficum sink and ficum main power. So anyhow, if you want to look at it today, get a scan gauge from AutoZone. Program it. You could be looking at it in a few hours, depending on how far AutoZone, if they have it in stock from you. If you've got more time, then if you have, now the next thing I want to cover is as far as with cell phones. If you have more time, order the Dash Boss. This is for your iPhone. Nothing better, at least that I know of. I know I don't know everything, but for the iPhone, Dash Boss by far the best to monitor things. If you buy the extra adapters, you can monitor your real fuel pressure, which nobody else can. And you can also monitor your exhaust gas temps and stuff with it. And it's still portable to where you can move it from car to car with it, with the Dash Boss for the iPhone. If you have the Android system, which I'll be using on this one, because most of you guys, that's what we're going to have, then you just want to get different adapters. Now, different adapters, there's a lot of different types out there. Your Chinese clones with the Elm 327, Bluetooth. Androids take Bluetooth. iPhones take Wi-Fi. So you get a different Bluetooth adapter, and you can go in and you can start monitoring things. Because again, we need to know, does it have fuel pressure and all the different, the critical things to check it. So here we have these with it. And then now this truck, so it's a crank no start. First thing I want to do is I'm going to go ahead and grab, this is just larger, but we can just simulate it like this Android phone. Let me go ahead and get this started up. I'm going to use Torque Pro, because Torque Pro seems to be the common one that everybody uses. Now on this one here, I just have the cheap little Chinese clone adapters, which works very well just for monitoring and stuff. So we're going to have that. We're going to go in. I'm going to look at the real-time information. Let me go ahead and communicate with the vehicle. Now what I've done here, I know the glare is bad. Let me set it down so the glare is better. You know, what I've done here, we're monitoring different things on this, and I'm gonna tell you what I'm monitoring and why. Vicom Sync. Vicom Sync is fuel injector control module synchronization. Sync is when it knows a camshaft, crankshaft position, and it can start firing the injectors. Then once it can start firing the injectors, just like a distributor, it'll start delivering fuel to the engine, and it can start. FMP is Vicom Main Power. You don't ever want it to go below 45 on a truck. Vans will drop because of the long run. So on vans, they'll drop down, but on trucks, you never want to see this below 45. It will still start in the high 30s, but it's once you start to have issues, or it's starting to fail when they get below 45. Also, while I'm talking about this, let me go ahead and pimp my own website. I do make the Vicoms. I sell them on eBay. Also, you can contact me here, Diesel Tech Ron, and sell them. And then the next thing we want to see is, most people call them HPOP, for high pressure oil pump or your injection pump. It has to be above 500. Once it's above 500, it'll go, once it's above 500 and it knows Vicom Sync, or it knows a cam and crankshaft position, it'll start turning the injectors on. If the voltage is there and the injectors are moving at the right time, then we have ignition, we have the motor to start. Now IPR, that's injection pressure regulator. This is important because we know how hard the pump works. It defaults to the 14.7, 14.8. I usually just round it up and say 15. We never want to see 15 or 85, because once it goes to 15, that's fully dumping, and 85 is fully closed. That means it can't reach desired pressure. So it's really important here, because if it's hitting 85, that tells us that we have a problem, we have a leak or something else. And that's what I was talking about earlier, which I'll cover here in a second, as far as what to look for when we have leaks and stuff. Now the third one that we want to look at that's really important is ICP voltage. And the only reason why this is important, it's only important key on, engine off, is because it's the only reference point we have to make sure that it's real. If I unplug the ICP sensor, it'll go to 0 volts, and then it'll use what they call inferred, all these readings as far as my IPR and my real pressure, it won't be real. The computer is trying to start the engine because it sees RPM, and then it's going to try to run it. So if you got to make sure the voltage is real. Once we confirm the voltage is real, key on, engine off, which is usually about a quarter of a volt, that's what this is, 0.2. If we had a better scanner, it might show 0.25, 0.28. The 0304s might show 0.16, 0.18, but roughly a quarter of a volt. So now we have these five. Every no start is going to be right here. We're going to find our problem right here in these. Vicom Sync, Vicom Main Power staying above 45, high pressure oil pump getting above 500, IPR not getting to 85, because 85 means it can't get to desired. 15, if it was reading 15, the only way it would do that is if it was dumping. And that's really rare, and I have a video showing it. That would be like if your ICP sensor would be reading, again, we would see it right here, we would find our problem. It would be reading, say, half a volt or a volt. It would think it has, whatever, 300 or 500 pressure without it turning. Of course, that's impossible because the pump's not turning. It can't have that kind of pressure. The most it can have is atmospheric pressure, say 15 PSI. You're going to be varying somewhere between 9 and 15 while you're sitting down here on Earth here. So it's not going to be as much higher than that. Since I said that, I also should say, unless you use a new style ICP sensor on a 03 style, 04 style truck, then it will be a little bit off. You might see this read 50 PSI, but if you start seeing it read hundreds, then that's because it's not right. You have a bad ICP sensor. So again, that's why all these are critical. So what I'm gonna do now to verify this no start, again, we wanna see Vicom Sync saying one. We wanna see this staying above 45. This has to get above 500. IPR not hitting 85. This, now that we've already confirmed that it's working, we can pretty much not even use ICP voltage anymore, because it's no longer important. It's no longer relevant because we know it's true, so we know we can count on the other ones. So I'm gonna go ahead and cycle the key, and during the pre-cycle, watch my Vicom voltage. Also, what I want to say is you want to listen to the sound of the Vicom. If it sounds spotty, you want it to sound like all the injectors are hitting. If you've got it and it sounds spotty, which I can't make that sound, but it, then you have injectors that aren't working. So you either have sticking injectors or you have a bad Vicom. Vicoms usually lose four at a time when they go bad, when they lose drivers. They can lose one at a time. Most common is four at a time, or sticking injectors. So I'm going to go ahead and cycle the key. I'm going to watch my Ficam power at that time. And also we're going to listen and try to hear what it sounds like. So let me go ahead and cycle the key. I want to be quiet, so hopefully we can hear the noise of it. Okay, that actually sounded good. Hopefully that picked up so we can hear the and it sounded, everything was good there. But as we can see, the voltage is dropping low. So we have a confirmed problem right here because we had good battery voltage. If this was dropping under 10, we might want to check as far as our input voltage. But we'd also find that here when we go to crank it. Also, when I get ones where people tell me everything's right, it still doesn't start, I ask them about the cranking, they'll send me a video, you know, because that's what I say, well, something's not right, send me a video, please. They'll send me a video and I hear, you know, the cranking on it. So obviously we've got an issue there. We have to have good cranking. But on this one, I got good voltage. I have bad Ficam. We saw how bad it drops. I'm going to go ahead and crank this one again because we want to see this one, this staying above 45, this reaching over 500, IPR hopefully under 50. Well, it'll be ideal if it's under 30, but hopefully it's under 50. And then we should see what comes out of specs as far as this one not wanting to start. So here I go cranking it. Okay, we've got one. We've got the Ficam, which is way out of specs. We've got more than enough injection pressure, and IPR percentage is good. So now from this, we can easily say this is a Ficam, because we had synchronization, voltage was out, that's our problem, that's our one confirmed problem. We have good high pressure oil pump, so we don't have a leak, and we had our IPR was in good, the percentage was good. So this one, we're going to do a Ficam. But while I'm talking about this and showing different things, let me go ahead and cover some of the other things, because again, I want to cover crank, no start, what's going on. So let's pretend this one is not so straightforward without the Ficam that we actually had a high pressure oil pump leak. So let me go ahead and cover that and tell you what to do. Okay, so this one had, let's just say it had a low high pressure pump, the high pressure pump pressure was low, not reaching 500, IPR was hitting 85. First thing you want to do is quiz the customer, or if you know the history of the vehicle, that's good. If it's an 03, 04, and it's not been touched, it's usually a pump. If it's at 05 and up, almost never a pump, hardly ever. I've done three bad pumps now. I just got my last one a couple weeks ago. The three bad pumps ever on these since they've been out. So 10 years on the 05 and up, not very common, seeing how it's all I do all day long with these problem child ones. So again, if it's not been touched, 03, 04, probably high pressure oil pump, could be an IPR valve. Both of them could be an IPR valve. Always try a known good one. If it's an 05 and up, do the dummy plugs, coupler, you're probably down the road if it's not reaching there. And the exception is if somebody has worked on this vehicle, if somebody's worked on it, if they've resealed the injectors, then not the outside external injector seals, but the one inside. If they resealed that or they got aftermarket injectors, to me, that's the first thing I suspect. If they touch the nipples on the oil rails or the fuel rails or whatever you want to call them, the oil rail that goes on top of the injectors, if they've touched those nipples, just it's suspected. Again, I've never seen an oil rail fail yet to this day unless somebody's touched on it. And even that, I probably get one, maybe three emails a day where people are telling me, oh, it can't be that, I just resealed it. You know, I'm sorry for keep saying this, but that's usually the problem is because they resealed it. So let's cover a few things here. What to look for with it and have if they do. Now, especially if they worked on it, the best thing I can suggest here is to get from, you got two choices. Again, if you're a shop, purchase one of these. You can buy these from Accurate Diesel, can't beat it. You take the IPR valve out, you screw this in, you stick your air hose on the end here, turn it on. I have different videos showing it what to do with it. You put this in there, 100% of the air go in there, you will find the leak. If it's something that still reaches 300, maybe 400 PSI, not enough to turn the injectors on, but you have an issue, then try to do it when it's warm. You pull the IPR, get it warmed up, and then it's no start hot, pull the IPR valve out, just screw this in there, and then inject it, you'll find it. You may have to pull the valve covers, but it'll work great, and you'll end up finding a leak with this thing. Can't beat it. Now again, if you have a shop, roughly $200, buy it, accuratediesel.com. Good people, they'll sell you one. It's good. If you don't, if you just have your own one you're fixing, you want to do it, I rent these. I'll rent them for $50 a week with a shipping. I charge $10 to ship them to you, and I also charge a deposit. That way, if you keep it, then I can buy another one to keep them in circulation. I have four of these that's always going and trying to help people out, not trying to make a killing off them, just trying to keep some out there in circulation and make a couple bucks for doing it. So if you need to rent them, I can rent them. If not, if you're a shop, buy it, because it's a great tool to own. If you don't want to spend the money and get that, the next thing you want to try, these adapters here, they're useful, they work. They're not 100% as far as the air noise going away, but they're very good. And this one's actually the quickest. You pull off the ICP valve on the passenger side, on the 04 and up, screw this in place of it, stick your air hose on there, and then just listen. Now, a little bit will leak through. This for sure, you pull off your oil filter cap, your oil fill cap on the driver, on the passenger side, and you inject air in here. If it leaks there, you'll definitely hear it and find it with this. A little bit leaks through the IPR valve over the passenger side, not enough to be accurate. If you don't find it there, you want to go over, take the driver's side valve cover off, unscrew in the back of the rail, and then put this in the driver's side and then inject air in it. That's the way to do it on the 04 and up. If you have an 03 with the round style oil rail on top, you want to get this adapter. Again, both of these, you can get them anywhere you want. I buy my stuff from freedomracing.com just because they sell good quality American made products at a good price. They'll even, because I mention them so much, if you use Diesel Tech Ron, you'll get a discount on it. But on the 03 style with it, once you pull it off, you see it. This is a smaller one. You put this on, and then you can inject air in each side. These are both effective. Just take a little bit more time, and you get a little bit of leakage because of the on the back of the pump. There is a dump that's for the where the when the IPR valve's open, that it dumps the oil back into the crankcase. So you get a little bit of leakage. You lose a little bit of pressure, and you also get the air noise. So again, one or two times, don't want to spend a lot of money, get these. If you've got if you're a shop, you're doing them all the time, you're making money at it, step up, buy it from Accurate Diesel and get it handled. Now, a few other things I want to just cover real quick, briefly, because I get a lot of people asking me on the IPR valve. What I can say here are a few things. One, if your pressure's under 200, because the spring pressure alone, there's like let's just say a gate or whatever inside here that stops the oil. The spring pressure alone should let it build up to 200. So if you have 200 plus, we're going to be thinking that most likely you've got a leak somewhere. If you have under 200, pull it off, look at your screen. Most likely you have part of the screen or so much contamination because somebody worked on it. Again, pulling history, you found out somebody just did the oil cooler or something else, or they've got a dormant oil cooler in there, and the dormant coolers comes apart, the seals, the gasket, everything else comes apart and plugs this up, which I show in a different video, and you have restriction, you can't get enough oil flow to do it. Because what happens, high pressure pumps flowing through here, this is the dump and controlling it, that's the IPR percentage that we look at. So anyhow, again, just to cover this, under 200 PSI, go after, suspect your IPR screen, and or the screen being broke or contaminated, holding the valve open. Especially if you've got under 50, it's most likely that, or you don't have any base oil pressure. I guess that's one thing I should have covered here. When you're cranking it, if it's back to a low ICP pressure and your IPR is hitting 85, then look at it as it's cranking, look at your dash gauge, make sure that it comes up. And also, on as far as relying on your dash gauge, you have to have a battery that's up and good. If your battery's, you know, again, if it's going cranking real slow, your gauges aren't going to respond. Your gauges are last on the food chain. So if you got to make sure that you got a real nice crank with this thing, and that way it has enough power voltage to keep all your modules alive and your gauge will respond. So if you got a good crank, everything else is good, then we can go ahead and count on your oil pressure gauge showing it. If you don't have base oil pressure, I have a video showing that. Start checking. If you don't have base oil pressure, if your crank's, you know, going wah, 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 most likely you lost a lifter. If you got a nice even crank, then you're probably fine there. Check the pressure relief valve, which I show, it's right behind your crank pulley. Take a 12 millimeter Allen, unscrew it, and then see if it's stuck. I show all that in a video. So if I'm saying this and it doesn't make sense, then, you know, watch a video and it'll show. Now, just briefly cover a couple more things. What this is just a test thing. You can get these wire ends that you can get them either from dieseltruckpartsdirect.com, or you cut them off an old 7.3 injector harness when you replace it. The same thing for the 7.3 injectors, the IPR, or the VGT for the turbo. All take the same connectors. If you get them from Diesel Truck Parts Direct, he has nice little pigtails you can use here
a lot more heavy duty, actually better than the factory. And you can put these on, you can replace your IPR one, your VGT on the turbo, that's the most common. Get it from there, you can make this test tool. Now I'll get people that tell me, that's also another way I know if you guys are trying to just kid me to get some answers, because I'll get people say, oh no, I plug it in and it clicks. If you want to eliminate your PCM and everything out of the system, as far as your powertrain control module or wiring, if you put 12 volts in ground to your IPR valve, that eliminates as far as the PCM or any wiring issue to the IPR. But also, again, it should be over 200 because spring pressure alone should hold back 200. So, but let's just say you've done everything, you've checked it, no leaks, but we suspect a PCM. You don't want to pay a couple hundred bucks or $500 to get a PCM and find out it wasn't needed. To eliminate your PCM or anything else going on with it or the wiring, just take your 12 volts and ground. If you want to use something in there to do it, you use some butt ends and make something, that's up to you. But if you do it, you put it on here, you make your tool here, you can plug it in. And then now that we have it hooked up, I'll just take 12 volts and ground and hook up to the battery. Nothing moves, nothing clicks, nothing makes any noise inside here. It should be quiet, because what it does, it just energizes this. That's how it's actually duty cycled. Nothing moves inside of it. The pressure does it, but it'll duty cycle it or lock it down. So when you put 12 volts in ground, 100% to it, what it's done is just locked your IPR valve closed for sure. So it's going to try to take all the pump pressure and move it to the injectors. And it's duty cycled. It's not as far as it's not a, it's not actually moving or opening up a percentage. It's cycled on and off. So when you put 12 volts in ground, nothing moves, you don't hear anything, you just locked it down. So again, to eliminate, to check it, you should be doing that.
Okay, here I have the IPR valve, 12 volts. I got it over there on the negative, I'm gonna touch 12 volts. The clicking you hear would just be the arcing of it as I touch it. But here you go. Again, nothing moves, that's what we expect. And hooking it up solid, it's not going to damage it. Ford tells us you can do this for 1-2 minutes, because obviously it's going to take time when you hook it up to go in and turn the key on to make sure that everything's going. So again, we're just applying 12 volts in ground. It's not getting hot, not damaging anything. You know, I wouldn't want to leave it on there for hours or days, but that again, that's testing the IPR or eliminating the powertrain control module and the wiring out of it as far as that goes. Okay, if you have an ICP problem with them, a couple things here. If it's an 03, early 04, made before September 23rd of 2003, your ICP sensor is not going to be up here in the passenger valve cover. It's going to be underneath the turbo. Most likely you have no voltage and it'll be leaking oil through it. I have videos showing that. If you have a problem with a 04 and up, a couple things you want to look for. Usually we have wire loom issues on some early made 04 ones. Pretty much most of them have been between February and April. But if not, and somebody's worked on it, what you want to look for is right here, if they've left this plastic retainer off on it, and it's that'll cause the wires to spread and make poor contact. They're either white or blue, I've even seen gray. But just make sure this plastic retainer's there and the seal, and we don't have any contamination inside of there. So if you have an ICP issue, go ahead and look right there for your connector, and if not, grab the sensor. And again, the sensor and the connectors from Diesel Truck Parts Direct. That's where I usually get him, because he actually has good quality stuff at a good price. His connectors are actually better than Ford, and he sells OE sensors, so that's pretty good.
Okay, if you have a problem with sync, most likely it's never a sensor, especially if it's factory sensors. It may be a ground issue with them. That's rare, where the block needs to be cleaned up. You guys in the snow country, you may see that out in the desert southwest where I'm at. We never see it. I do see issues with aftermarket sensors on them, so be careful with that as far as the cam and crank sensors. I do see that with them, so make sure you use a quality one if you're using an aftermarket one. Every one I've ever had, it's always been a wiring issue, so that's what I want to cover, and it's almost always. Now, if you're looking at no sync, if you have the RPM signal, then you have the crank one, because the crank is RPM, but no sync, then it's got to be in the cam issue. So what you can try, because it's almost always in the wiring loom, this right here is your upper fuel filter, one of your fuel lines, and this wire right here, what I'm touching, is the one that goes down to the cam sensor. So while somebody's cranking it and you're safely over here, go ahead and just wiggle it, you know, go up and down on it while it's cranking, and see if your sync comes back, because usually it's a wiring issue here. Another issue while I'm right here, if somebody's put a stud on this upper corner,
not the very front by the dipstick, but the upper top corner of the valve cover. They put a stud in there instead of a bolt holding the valve cover down. So that's another area where we'll see the wiring. And the last place I'll show you right here.
Areas I want to cover as far as wiring, no sink or drivability issues underneath the hood that I see that's kind of common. We see 3 or 4 a year. If people put the main wiring loom where it drapes, it should go behind the air filter right here. So we want to have this main wire loom go behind the air filter. I'll see guys or whatever, they push it down on the air filter, that stresses it and causes them to break. So make sure your main wire loom is behind here. And also that make sure if somebody's had the body off down underneath here where your main, the same main wire loom where it connects over here in front of the master cylinder, make sure those are plugged in. Don't try to seat them actually. What I like to try to do is pull them out. If they pull out, then they weren't connected or latched properly. So what I just do is tug on them. There's a couple of them here. Just tug on these ones right down here for the main wire loom and see if they come out. If they do, then that may be your issue. But only see those if the body's been off, somebody's done the head gaskets. So let's go ahead and go inside on the other stuff after we get the FICM on.
Okay, here we have the same truck a few minutes later. I put on one of my rebuilt program tested FICMs on it. And then let's go ahead and see what we get now. I'm going to go ahead and cycle the key so we can hear the pre-clatter and also monitor the FICM voltage. Okay, that's all passing. So let's go ahead and look at the difference here and also make sure it's starting. Okay, pretty much as you can see, we've got sync, we've got our voltage above 45 all the time, we've got a running vehicle, which is best. We have our high pressure oil pump here that was reading high, and injection pressure was where we want to see it, and then also the ICP voltage. I just turned the key off so it's having to refresh here and go down. So pretty much, hopefully this helps you out on diagnosing your nose starts. A couple things I want to say is if my videos help you, please like and subscribe. And for those of you that's found it in your heart to donate, I really appreciate it. I have 4 kids with 2 in college, and it all helps out. I appreciate it very much. Thank you.